My name is Gary Sinclair. I work for a company called Tactile Music. For Deep Ocean's exhibition, I am carrying out all the work for the design and the sound environments in each space. In the background, this is the inside of the submarine as we enter the exhibition. Well, the inspiration has been probably the exhibition itself and what is incorporated in the exhibition, and the science behind the exhibition. I pretty much tried to keep it very authentic. So all the sounds, for instance, for this piece are original and real submarine sounds, just balanced and crafted and kind of tweaked and processed a little bit to make them sound kind of subtle enough that it's not going to be overbearing in the exhibition space and not going to be too overpowering. Before I tried to look at any of the soundscapes or actually start to write it, I looked at the science of sound in deep ocean and how sound worked in the ocean and how it was perceived and how it travelled. Sound being a waveform, it was very important that we accurately represent how it moves and what we, if we were there, how we would hear it. What I was conscious of with this, with any musical components of this piece, had to be random rather than melodic or structured. I was very conscious of people not being able to tune in and recognise any sort of melody. I think if they do that in the exhibition space, then they're immediately transported out of the space itself and into a musical world rather than it being retaining them within that environment. The speed of sound is a lot faster in the ocean. It moves a lot quicker than it does through air. But it also is absorbed a lot quicker. Now, it also led me to find out about a thing called a SOFAR channel. It stands for Sound Ranging and Fixing, which is actually a channel of sound that travels through the ocean. And any sound that appears above or below it is refracted or bent into the sound channel. So basically, it's if you sit in the sound channel, you'll hear everything that occurs in the ocean, which is fascinating. It also travels slowly, so you might start to hear something very far away. It could be up to, 3 kilometers away, which is interesting, and it'll get louder and louder and louder the closer it gets to you. So it's quite fascinating. So therefore, I've tried to make things repeat themselves at different levels coming up, gradually getting louder and louder.